In today's episode, I'm going to show you how to cook Anambra onugbu soup with just 1,000 naira. But before then, if you've not subscribed to my channel, click on the red button. Also click on the bell button, which will enable you get on my video whenever a new video is uploaded. Thanks. Onugbu soup is a traditional soup in Igbo land. It can be eaten with eba, fufu, pounded yam, and semovita. This means that any occasion without onugbu soup is not yet complete. There are so many methods of cooking onugbu soup, but today I'm going to show you my own method of cooking this special soup in Igbo land. For the soup to be a typical bitterleaf soup, let me give you the ingredients needed. Number one, washed bitterleaf. You have to wash the bitterleaves very well. You wash it that the bitterness will not be there again. If the bitterleaf is bitter, you're not going to enjoy the soup. Number two, cocoyam. We have so many cocoyams, but the one that is used for bitterleaf soup is called edole in Igbo land. If you use any other cocoyam, you will not enjoy the soup. If you look at the bottom of the cocoyam, you will see that it's greenish or whitish in color. Please don't make the mistake of using Quaker oats. It will not give the true taste of bitterleaf soup. The next one is meat. You can use any type of meat. And another thing is fish, dry fish. You can use any type of fish. And the next is fresh pepper. Dry pepper is the best. But if you don't see dry pepper, use fresh pepper. The next is stockfish. Stockfish is good for bitterleaf soup. And crayfish. Crayfish is the major thing, one of the major things in onugbu soup. And local spice. I will use just one out of this. Use the one prepared with castor seeds so that it will give me the true taste of onugbu soup or bitterleaf soup, not the one prepared with egusi. The next ingredient is palm oil, extracted from palm fruits. The first thing to do is to wash the meat very well. Wash it with salt so it will be neat. Wash the meat. After washing the meat, you steam the meat and steam it very well. I want to sound a warning. Don't add onions. Don't add onions. Once you add onions, you've spoiled the soup. There's no Igbo person that will cook onugbu soup or bitterleaf soup with onions. You're going to add while steaming the meat is just maggi and salt. Don't add onions so that it will not spoil your soup. Add water. Allow to boil very well so that the ingredients will be absorbed by the meat. The meat is okay now. Look at the meat. It has absorbed a lot and it is sweet now. The next thing is to boil the cocoyam. Remove the back and pound. Pound your cocoyam so that it will be stretchy, because it will help the soup to be slippery and give it a good taste. This is how the cocoyam will look like after pounding. Look at it very well. at it very well, it should be stretchy so that it will be very sweet. It is time for us to start preparing our soup. So the first thing to do is to add the pounded cocoyam inside the steamed meat. Add it inside the steamed meat. Then add some water. The quantity of water you're going to add depends on the quantity of the ingredients that you're using. So allow to boil for about 5 minutes. Add pepper. Stir. Anything you add, you stir. Add crayfish and stir again. Cover the pot and allow to boil for 2 minutes. Add local spice. Ogilibo. Add local spice. I told you I'm going to use one out of those two. I used one. Cover the pot and allow to boil for 5 minutes. Now add the bitter leaf, which is the major thing, which is the major ingredient. Remember to squeeze the water very well. Stir very well. As you can see, a thickener is dissolving. It will make the soup to come together. Add oil. And this is the best time to add dry fish and stockfish, especially when they were washed with hot water. But when it was not washed with hot water, add at the beginning. That's why steaming your meat. But when you wash it with hot water, add it at the end because it's soft already. Our soup is almost done. Add 2 cubes of Maggi, depending on the quantity of the soup. But for this quantity, I added 2 cubes. Stir very well. It does not dissolve very well, so I have to allow it to dissolve. Look at it, the soup is now done. The soup is okay. Look at it. The thickener has dissolved. You have to add some salt. Taste and add some salt. The soup is done. The thickener has dissolved very well and is ready to be eaten. Soup is ready to be eaten. This is where we're going to end our today's video. Hope you enjoyed my video. Drop your comments. Thank you.